Hello everyone. Today we'll be starting our new module, which is called Electromagnetic Theory, wherein we'll study the introduction to electromagnetism and what are scalar and vectors, a quick recap to the things you already know, and what are scalar and vector fields. In early days, electricity and magnetism were treated as different subjects. In the year 1820, Oersted observed that an electric current could deflect a magnetic compass needle. Later, it was postulated by Ampere that all magnetic phenomena are due to electric charges in motion. Furthermore, in 1831, Faraday discovered that movement of a magnet generates an electric current, or time-varying electric field gives rise to magnetic field and vice versa. Maxwell and Lorentz suggested that electricity and magnetism are in fact interconnected and presented a theory called electromagnetism. The variations of electric and magnetic intensity, E and H, are transverse in nature and also to the directions of wave propagation. The E and H wave patterns for a traveling electromagnetic wave obey the fundamental equations known as Maxwell's equations. In fact, that is the heart of this module, which are the mathematical abstractions of the experimental findings. So let us dive into the important concepts. What are scalar and vector? Scalar quantity consists of only magnitude. Example in physics are energy, work, mass, temperature, etc. Vector quantity has magnitude and direction both. Example, velocity, acceleration, electric and magnetic field intensities, E and H. Now, magnitude of a vector A is given as mod A, that is a symbol, which is equal to root of AX square plus AY square plus AZ square, where AX, AY, AZ are the X, Y, Z components of vector A. Now, what is a unit vector? First of all, the notation of unit vector is there is a cap over A. So that is A cap. It is a vector whose magnitude is unity. A vector is equal to I cap AX plus J cap AY plus K cap AZ, where I, J, K are the unit vectors along X, Y, Z axis. Also, vector A is equal to the magnitude of A times the unit vector. Now, what is a scalar product or the dot product? Scalar product of two vectors A and B is A dot B is equal to mod A mod B cos theta, which is A B cos theta, where theta is the angle between the vectors A and B. Now, important to understand is, as the name suggests, A dot B is a scalar quantity. So two vectors have been converted by this scalar product to a scalar quantity. Example, work done by a force, that is W, is equal to F dot D, where F is the force, D is the displacement. Vector product of two vectors A and B is equal to mod A mod B sine theta n cap. What is n cap? N cap is the unit vector perpendicular to the plane containing A and B. Now, how do you find A cross B? A cross B is a vector quantity, and A cross B is given as in the form of determinant I, J, K, and here you have on the first row, on the second row, you have AX, AY, AZ, the components of A, and this one are the components of B. So it's very easy to open it up. Now, what is a scalar triple product? Scalar triple product is for three vectors A, B, C. Now, the scalar triple product is denoted by A dot B cross C, and the final output is a scalar quantity. It represents the volume of parallelepiped formed by the three vectors A, B, C. Now, A dot B cross C in terms of determinant is expressed as, we just replace I, J, K here and we put AX, AY, AZ, BX, BY, BZ, CX, CY, CZ. So again, we open it up in the same fashion as we did earlier. What is a vector triple product? Vector triple product of three vectors ABC is a vector quantity. It is represented as A cross B cross C. It is not associative, or we can say A cross of B and B cross C is not equal to A cross B cross C. Vector quantity, vector identity A cross B cross C is equal to B into A dot C minus C into A dot B. This is the identity we will be using, and this is also known as popularly back cap rule. A cross of B cross C can be easily calculated using the vector or cross product. So we just find the B cross C using the simple vector product, and then again we take the vector product with A. What are scalar and vector fields? Say a physical quantity Y is expressed as F of XYZ, where F is a continuous function of position coordinates XYZ. The region in which the function F represents the quantity Y is called field of Y. A physical quantity Y can be scalar or vector, and hence has associated fields called scalar and vector fields. So a scalar field, which is commonly denoted by phi or psi, if a scalar quantity psi or phi like energy, potential, temperature is expressed by a continuous function in a region, then the field created is called scalar field. Say phi is equal to phi of XYZ. Now, what is a vector field? Vector field is can be any vector. Okay, it can be denoted by any vector. So if a vector quantity A, like electric field, magnetic field, force, velocity, etc., is expressed by a continuous function in a region, then the field created is called a vector field. Say A is equal to A of XYZ. Thank you.